Sprinters in the house. It's a King Groom KLP1 with my name on it. Let's take a look inside. The printer is well packed with attention to details like these cut-on edges to reinforce the whole packaging. Don't underestimate the weight of this printer, it is really heavy. This is really a heavy part. This is completely made of metal. Super solid and super heavy. I've never seen something like this before. All metal frame. So that's what we got. The manual, some tools, the pen for the display, all the covering, the housing panels we will install at the next step, and the printer itself. Super solid. Let's go. This seems to be the door with a nice magnet stripe. Now it's time to put on some screws. Super easy. Before mounting this side, here we have to remove a screw. Here's a sign for the screw. And also there, this saved the mechanic. So at the moment, this can't be moved. Now removing the screw right here. And then this should become free. When this screw is removed, it's possible to move it in the Y direction, and now the second screw become visible, this one, because this is still locked, can't move in an X direction. So now this is loose, and now I can also move X and Y. Okay, and the last screws are for Z, they are here. And this is shown on this paper. Just on this paper, you see again the position of the screws. Z screws are removed, Y screw and X screw. Now everything is free and we can go on assembling with the covers. The top cover is also mounted. Let's have a closer look to the printer. This is the back side. Here we got the filament runout sensor. Power connector, everything is metal, this thing is super heavy, this is a big fan. On this side we got some connectors for Ethernet, USB and for a camera. And from the front side the display, the print bed, that's it. And we can see the Core XY belts. Power up, we got a nice Leighton King Groom KLP1. That's the display. On default, it is set to Chinese language. Just can be set up with this pen. Oh, also with fingers. Didn't mention this. But it's not so easy to reach. It's really tight here on the frame, so better with this. Then I'm setting up the language. Now it's on Chinese symbol. I go here, go to German. Okay. Now it's in German. So then everything can be homed. That is getting up. It's also much more easy to work on this display here. It's a bit covered from the print bed. Let's have a look on the settings. The display is not that easy. I just wanna show you the minimum we have to do here. We go to network and there we can see our network here, the Fritzbox. And we also can see the IP address. This is important for the user interface, the Clipper user interface. The rest we can set up on the computer. Meanwhile, I let the printer do the Z leveling. This is just he doing alone. Just go to settings and then to the Z leveling. And he will follow several points on the print bed and measure the Z offset. And we go to the computer. Now, I just entered the IP address, like seen on the printer, and now we got the whole dashboard, and this is much more easy to set up like on the printer itself. And here we can see the leveling process also for Z. Here we got
the several set distances, what he's doing at the moment. When it's done, then click save config and send it. Now the set configuration is saved. So let's run a bit through the menu. Let's go to the setup. And here we got also the language. At the moment is German. I will switch it to English. Better understanding. So after leveling, we can start the input shaper. These are macros. They are already prepared. Just see them here. Some Chinese signs and then shaper. I think this is the correct one. And when this is clicked, we can also see here that he is testing the frequency. Here we also can see what the printer is actually doing. This works nice. Let's go to the printer. See? And we can hear it. This is vibrating. It's doing now the input shaping completely alone. It's super important for fast print speeds. So it's quiet. Let's take a look on the computer. And we can see he's still testing the best frequencies and is finished. We click again, save config, and then we click send, and then this is saved into the printer. The same has to be done with the Z offset. Before we go on with the filament loading, we have to install the printer on Cura. This is the USB stick, which is delivered with the printer. Here we can see what's in it. And let's start how it is shown in the manual. We have to look for Cura and then following the folder path, Cura resources, and that's the FAT. Then we go to share, click on Cura again, resources and quality. Here we can see already a lot of printers, and now we have to move this folder, the KPL1 Kingroon folder, into here. Not into a folder, into this directory. And here we can see it, there it is. And the same has to be done also with the other files. It's super easy. And when this is done, we can start up Cura. Should be a latest version. And go to add printer, non-Ultimaker printer, a non-network printer. And then here we go to K, Kingroon. And there it is, the KLP1. And this is just there if we put all these folders and all the other steps right before into the path of Cura. Otherwise, we wouldn't find this. Yeah, and then we select this, KPL1, I already did. The printer is here on all the other printers we got. We select it, and here we can see it. And we got also all the settings. I think this is mostly for PLA. When we take a look at the temperature, 200 degree, but it's quite fast. When you take a look at the speed, print speed 350 millimeter per second. Acceleration till 10,000. I would say this is for PLA. Just was wondering on the support settings. This looks a bit low. Support Z top distance. I will put this to 0.8 for better remove the support. And this here is a bit much. The support XY distance. I put this to 0.4 and save it. So now the printer is installed on Cura, but to use it with Wi-Fi, we have to do a bit more. Just follow the manual, go to extensions right there, then post-processing, modify G-code, and we create a thumbnail like written here with 50 pics. Same as shown in the manual. And now we have to enter the API key. For this step, we go here to Marketplace and we have to install the Octoprint plugin. This is not installed as default, so we have to do this. I already did this here. You can just enter in the search field Octo and you will find this, and then press install. After installing, you have to restart Cura, that it could be used. So now Cura is restarted. Then we go to our printer, manage printers, and then take a look. Here we can see it, this is normal PLA. I don't use the filament holder on the back. I usually use all these dry boxes, cause in Germany here it's super cold and much humidity in the room. So it should be stay dry. And the Bowden is quite long enough, which is already installed on the printer. This will fit. So I will put the filament in now.
I'm preheating the nozzle for PLA. You can see how it rises. So temperature is reached about 200 degrees. I go for 50 millimeter and on load. Stuck for a first moment, but now it's loading. Yeah, you can see it. The Bowden is moving. Loading. Ah, and we can see it there. There it comes. Okay, this works. No filament is loaded. So go back to temperature and cooling. So now I'm putting some 3D lac on the PI, on the print plate. Here we are again on fluid, here on jobs, and I marked this PA test, pressure advanced calibration. Yeah, and I want to print this now. So go to print and let's see what happened. Bed temperature is reached. 60 degrees, now the nozzle is heating till 200. You can see everything here on the screen. And this works nice. We got our small icon here, the pressure advanced test. Also here we can read it. And the printer is starting. So it's done. The only thing is, this bed should move down now that I can release the PI plate. Because it's super close to the nozzle, but it works. First I want to move it manually, but this works. Now we can take a look what he has done here, and we can see differences. When we start here, I would say this is a bit too low, not easy to see. Maybe this is better. Here we can see. Here it's too low, there it's too much, and then it becomes equal. The mid area looks really good, and here we can see at first it's too much, and after this is too low. So I will choose one of these numbers, something like 0.048 or 52. Let's take a look again here. Yeah, here we can see it quite good. And this is a time, this number here is a time. There we will set it. At the moment it is on zero. And I will go take a look here at, I think, 0.032. This is about here. This looks most homogeneous. Yeah, so I will set this now to, maybe we can tip it here. So now this is set. I refreshed this side, F5 pressing, and we can see here I can't tip it in, so I have to move this button carefully, but it is almost there where I wanted it. And we can see it's also refreshed in the printer. We can see the same number here. Yeah, and now the printer is ready, and I would say let's print the first Benchy. Let's go to jobs, and here we got already some jobs. There is a Benchy Fast. Can you see it here? So, and yeah, first I have to put this back and clean it, and then we can start printing. Here is it good visible how to select the right number, and also the set offset looks really nice. Super well done. Let's see how good is the adhesion of the bed. This works super nice, perfect. Everything removes lot of small plastics here, but no problem to remove this. So the set offset is quite perfect from the first moment, and also this here set up this pressure was really easy, so no big deal. So print plate is cleaned again, printer is ready, last Benchy selected, and print, and now everything starts. Super easy, I like it. So let's see. Here we got our icon, that's working, printer is printing, that's a bit slower, but when it's rising, hopefully we'll see some speed in there. From the outside I would say it's normally loud, but when we open it, it's much louder, because of the fan from the hot end. So it makes absolutely sense that there is a housing all around. I think this could also be transparent, that we could see a bit more what happens inside, but it's also super nice looking. And also is here, and I shut off the the light. You can see the Kingroon KLP-1 inside some red. That's it.
So let's have a look how to slice apart. Here we got some STL. It's a strut part. Just drag and drop into Krewer. Here we got it. This is just for testing. So two walls and take a look after slicing. So I didn't change too much. Just the Z offset. Let's go to preview. This was all automatically set. Just will take a closer look. I just want to modify the support interface density. So we go here and enable it. And it's already set to 100%. That's nice. So we slice again. So, and now we see 100% support interface density. This makes removing the support much more easy. I figured out it looks just a bit thick. We don't need 1 millimeter. 0.6 is enough. So 0.6, this means 3 layers. Slice again. And now we see it starts with the normal support. I think this was 10% setted. And then we got 3 layers of 100% density on the interface. And then it builds up normally. Yeah, and this we will print next. So still printing on the Benchy. I think it should take about 25 minutes. Was set here. Yeah, it looks good from the first view. Let's have a look at the temperatures in the room. 16 degrees. Yeah, 16, and inside here it's much warmer, 31. It's also on the outside. Let's take a look inside, 50 degrees. Yeah, this housing makes absolutely sense. It keeps the temperature inside. 16 degrees would be too low. Even if it is not super close, there is a small gap, but it's much more homogeneous from temperature inside, even if your room temperature is not that warm. Benchy is growing. Here we can see the actual speeds. Printing at up to 220, I saw there. Really interesting, all the starters. You can see here. Completed print time 23 minutes. And remain 7 minutes. Yeah, I think for this basic information, this display makes absolutely sense. Especially when the Z bed is much more up. Just for information. For controlling, I would use the fluid computer interface and also wireless LAN. You see here. Nothing, no SD card, nothing, just wireless LAN coupled. They say maximum 5 meters. Yeah, I think these are, let's say 4 meters, maybe 5 meters, but there is no problem. This works nice. And it's coming to an end. So now it looks really nice. No stringing, very little bit. Overhang looks nice. Ah, let's see. 90%. Also, this works nice with the container. Something to set up on Kira and the Wi-Fi, but at the end, this was not that much work. Everything worked out nice. And we got a full remote control Wi-Fi printer, which is really fast. And here it is. Benchy is ready. This looks good out of the printer. Also, the bed adhesion is perfect. KLP-1 just found its final place, just beside the Kili X-Max. And it's really small printer, so it fits super in this gap here. We need 40 in width, 41 in height, 36 in depth. And there we got it. Perfect little printer. Print bed is cleaned and it's ready for the next job. Well, this Benchy came out really nice. We still need some information for the support, if removing the support also works nice. And this will I test now here with this strut part. And now let's check if it's printing possible via Cura direct. First I will see if the printer is connected again. So we have to reconnect because I shut it off for a moment. There we got it. Works super nice. Remember, you just have to type in the IP address and you are already in Fluid and got everything you need. So, and there would be two possibilities. One would be we could here to our go to our jobs and insert via drag and drop, or also here we are at and G-code, or we try to do it directly on Cura. So it's sliced. Let's do a last check. Two walls, some infill, and a lot of support. Yeah, this will be interesting. Let's check again. Support Z distance 0.18, bottom distance 0.2, XY 0.4. That's my standard. Okay, then press print via Octoprint. Let's see what happened. Okay, it changes directly to Fluid. And we can see here printing the front gear upper strut. This is what we saw already. And I think we also should see it here on jobs. Ah, there it is. Yeah, here it is. And the job already starts with heating the heat bed. So this is what we did in our settings, that it start immediately. And no extra button to press. We can see it also here on the graphic. Yeah, and now we have to wait till it's done. What's the time? I think the time we can see here on the jobs, the estimated time, here, 32 minutes. So it's a bit longer than the fast Banshee. And it started printing the strut. Looks really good. I'm super happy with the Z adhesion and the Z offset. This works perfect from the first moment. The printer is really fast. And here we got our nice picture. This also works super nice. Then we know for sure what is printing. And you see the print speed up to, what was this, 232. So again, super fast. This year I will change for next the bed temperature. This is default set to 60 degrees. This can be set lower to 50, and then after the first layers down to 40. This also works super nice and saves a lot of energy. And the KLP1 finished. Let's have a look. First I want to see how easy it is to remove. This is quite perfect. This is absolutely perfect distance for that offset. This also could have done be printed with a skirt, so the brim was not necessary. Just want to see the Z offset again, and this is super perfect, this special tool. So I can go under here, yeah, and this works nice. I can go a bit closer. It's super easy to remove. Now I am at 0.18. The default was just at 0.1. Maybe this also works, but the surface looks good. Easy to remove. Think this is not bad. Just out of the box. Yeah. This works super nice. Yeah. I think we got a cool printer. Also the support from inside was easy to remove. So I think this is a good setup with the 0.18. Very little stringing visible. But this was super normal PLA and printed quite fast. So it's time to print some more interesting parts with the KLP1. Here we got latest strut construction from the JRM1C and some servo brackets. So a lot of different parts. They will print it with PolyAir 1, some special PLA. And it's getting printed. And the parts are growing. I want to see the differences between this one and from the Bamboo Lab. We got both. This is PLA Tough from Bamboo Lab. And this is Polylight from CVD Lab. It's not so smooth, the surface. Here we got the parts.
left from the Bamboo Lab from PLA Tough. It's a very good surface, also on the side, super homogeneous. Here, this is still not perfect. These gaps between the lines up here, just above from the support, also around this hole, there is a big gap, so this is won't be super stable, this part. There has to be some improvements done. Okay, and here we got three printed by the KLP. This is the latest one with my latest settings, a bit hotter and a bit more flow. But the print time on both were the same, and I would say it is both nearly the same material, just from different brands, some kind of tough PLA. So the surface is not that smooth, but this could be that here is another mode used. This is lines, and this I must check. This is default setting, maybe rectangular. Also here on the side, this is not that smooth like on the Bamboo Lab. Bamboo Lab is really a quality for its own. So I made a bit more light. This is even matte. Maybe that's not so good visible. But here are some ups and downs. Maybe you can see it here better. And this is an absolutely clean surface. Also, the seam is not that clean. We can see some small gaps inside. Here the seam, it's there, looks much better, even not visible. So, and let's take a look on the lower side. The lower side looks not that bad compared to the Bamboo Lab. I would say a bit better. We don't have this big gap on the circle, between this, all around the circle. But there are still gaps between the lines. I don't know why. Here the default setting was 120% flow. I set it now down, I think, to 108. Maybe I go a bit up. So this would be the same. This is just the footprint from the print plate. Here with more flow, it looks exactly the same like on the Bamboo Lab. But then we got on the side. Result was a bit too much, so just small steps for optimizing. So I would say the Bamboo Lab, as conclusion, the Bamboo Lab has still the better quality, but it is not that bad really for this printer. Not that bad. On both wasn't used this ironing setup.
It's time to print the first big part with the KLP1. This is the new designed elevator for the JM1 from Lightweight PLA. Just presetted the new print profile, and let's take a look.
Here it is. Elevator is ready printed. It's the first Lightweight PLA print with the KLP1. And here the new elevator is ready installed on the JM1. We can see the reason why. The first design has a very long nose, and this stuck in the ground while landing with this nose, and the elevator broke. And this time the nose is much shorter, so even with big deflections it won't stuck. First test of the new landing gear. The suspension works. It's also strong enough here. Maybe this has to be reinforced later on, but we will see. But this works super well, and also the mechanism. This is 1 4-gram servo, so super mini. So the KLP1 is approved for lightweight PLA and prints superb from the first moment. The clearer profile you will find on my Patreon. There you will make it online, and you got a super working fast printer for a very low price. Sum up for this one, a link to the printer you will find underneath in the video description. I wish you a wonderful week, and we see us in the next video. Bye bye.